Hi everyone! In this video, I will present the new features released in WMS version 6.03, July 2023. We start with Xhoppers updates. With this release, we improve our integration with Vision AI. Vision AI is software for CCTVs installed in a store that detects in real-time suspicious gestures and passes automatic alerts to the Xhoppers headsets, notifying the staff of a shoplifting attempt. With this release, we add posting of vision alerts and footage from cameras to the channel. Like that, in case of a theft, not only is it possible to get a notification to the headsets, but also see right away a footage of what exactly happened. Also in this release, we add transcription of all the interactions that happen over the Xhoppers headsets. All the chats between shop assistants can now be recorded, transcribed and posted to the channel. Next, we plan to add posting of requests coming from QR codes and tablets. Like that, it will be possible to get a complete picture. So everything, including chats between shop assistants, requests coming from customers, vision alerts and alerts coming from other integrated in-store equipment, all of that will be recorded and posted to the conversation. We are very excited to announce the release of Cloud Analytics. Starting from this version, premium collaboration users get a new tab called Analytics. In this tab, they can see a report, a dashboard that resembles CDR-View, but it is much better. First of all, with Analytics, you get ACLs. The first ACL is Can Use Analytics. After you enable this permission for certain premium users, those will get the new Analytics tab in their collaboration. The second ACL is Can See Analytics of a certain ACL group. This means you can enable certain managers to see the data only for a certain group of people, but restrict them from seeing the events of other people. Also, with Cloud Analytics, users can have scheduled reports to email, where they can specify the frequency, the format, and the recipients. Another improvement is that with Cloud Analytics, you can see the detailed call flow. In case of call transfers, in the old CDR-View, it was just one record. In Cloud Analytics, you can see different parts of the same call as separate records. So you can track all the details of this call. With that said, we announced that we do not plan to deliver any further updates for the old CDR-View, since the new Cloud Analytics covers all the CDR-View scenarios, but the old CDR-View will continue to exist. In terms of Cloud Analytics, collaboration users only get this dashboard that contains only call-related data, while XBiz users have self-service analytics, more predefined dashboards, and in addition to calls, they see web conferences events and, in the future, also chats. In Dial Plan, we have a new call group strategy, priority-based call routing. It allows you to prioritize agents based on their assigned priority level from 1 to 5. In that way, you can have a full control over how you want to distribute queue calls efficiently, for example, first to the most qualified agents or, on the contrary, first to the first level support members. To start using this new strategy, let's select a call group, edit strategy, set strategy priority. You can also specify the priority for the dynamic members. And then let's open our call group and assign the priorities in waves to the call group members. You can have up to 10 members of each priority, so the maximum number of 50 call group members for such call groups. Previously, we delivered neutrals TTS, so a more human-like TTS, for sounds menu. And with this version, we enable neutral TTS by default also in Dial Plan. In addition, via set application, you can now set TTS voices in different languages. In this version, we add several features that simplify the job of a system administrator. Remember, when you need to add a new user on a system or a few users, you need to configure their user preferences manually, one by one, and it is really time-consuming. You no longer need to do it. Now you can just copy preferences from one of the existing users. You need to select a user or multiple users whose preferences you want to update. Then click on Preferences below, Copy Preferences from User, and a new dialog opens, enabling you to select the source user. By the way, you can create a virtual user, assign them a service license and set up all the default preferences, and then use that user as a source for updating other users' preferences. One more amazing feature is the new ACL permissions viewer. It is really time-consuming and it is a pain to understand which permissions certain groups have. You need to open every group one by one, so you no longer need to do it. With the new ACL permissions viewer, you get all of them in just one place, in one sheet, all of them together. With the release of WMS 6.03, it is important to emphasize that filling out users' emails is very important. That's needed for a number of security reasons. First of all, already in the next release, we plan to give users an option to reset their own web password without involving the admin. Second, already in this release, we added an additional level of protection for collaboration access based on the user's location and IP. In case someone is trying to log in from a new location, we ask them to confirm this operation via email. Next login from the same IP will not require any confirmation. This feature is currently disabled by default because we plan to add email validation for users before rolling it out to everyone. But we recommend you enable it and try it, and you can already deliver it to those customers who need it right away. Just make sure their email addresses are filled out properly. And now let's talk about some product updates. With this release, we add CLASSOUND SMS option directly into collaboration call dialog. Imagine you are calling a customer and they are not answering, so you can send an SMS right from the call dialog. We delivered API endpoints allowing you to control the web conference. Those include the ability to create, edit, and delete a room. If you have a third-party software from where you need to schedule conferences, this is what you need. Previously, we used ACL cannot use CDR-View for ex-Caracal permissions, but now ex-Caracal got an ACL on its own, cannot use ex-Caracal. And please pay attention, the new ACL is set to cannot use ex-Caracal by default. So please set up the ACL rules for your customers using ex-Caracal properly with this WMS update. And finally, big news for our Teams for Wildix integration. We added sync of user presence status from Teams to collaboration and XBs. This is the first part of our presence sync improvements for Teams. Next, we plan to add a two-way sync, so also from Wildix to Teams, and user status mapping between Teams and Wildix. That's all for today. These are just the most important features and updates, but please read our documentation and changelog for more details. Thanks for watching and see you next time.